Lord, your word is truth. Sanctify us by truth. A young man came to the pastor for a confession. And he was all excited about doing that. And he knelt down and said, "Father, I am a sinner. Forgive my sins." And he said, I have committed sin against the 15th commandment. The pastor was taken aback. He said, "All that I know is 10 commandments. Where is this 15th commandments?" He said, "Yes, Father." And he was a little hesitant in explaining to him. And he said, "You know, 6 plus 9 is 15. The priest said, "Yes, I know that 6 plus 9 is 15. But where this commandment came from?" He said, "Sixth commandment and the ninth commandment put together. Sixth commandment, thou shalt not commit adultery. And the ninth commandment, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's wife. 6 plus 9, 15th commandment." And today's gospel, Jesus is talking about commandment. A young man comes to Jesus and says, "What do I do to have eternal life?" Jesus says, "Follow the commandments. You know the commandments. Nothing more important than keeping the commandments." And here Jesus meant about the Mosaic commandments, the 10 commandments in Exodus chapter 20. The 10 commandments, follow the commandments, honor your father and mother, should not steal, cannot kill. And Jesus goes on to explain. Gospel of John, in the farewell discourse, Jesus is talking about commandments. And then he adds a little more. He says, "I give you a new commandment." What is this new commandment all about? And he never gives anything new. It is the same old commandment. Love one another. Love your neighbor. Pray for your enemies. Love your neighbor. But the new commandment, Jesus makes a slight difference. And that makes a big world of difference. Love one another as I have loved you. As I have given you an example. He bends down, washing the feet of the disciples. A servant leadership. A suffering servant. As I have loved you. And Jesus comes as an example par excellence. As I have loved you. There is no greater example than the life of Jesus itself. And you know, the gospel today is talking about this new commandment of love. And Jesus reminds his apostles. And he says, "I'm going, but the Spirit will come. The Spirit of truth. Spirit will inspire you. The Spirit will lead you to the truth. And he will remind you of all that I have taught you. All that I have instructed you." When Jesus called his disciples, you know what happened. They left their family, their wife, their property, their fishing nets, boats, their profession, everything. They gave away everything and followed Jesus. Now, Jesus, next week is Ascension, and Jesus goes, and Jesus is telling, "I'll be going away. I'll be leaving you." And you know, the psychological stress the apostles would have had. If this man leaves, what is going to be our life and our future? We trusted this guy. We followed him. Now he's abandoning us. And how can we face our family again? How can we go back to our profession? We have given our nets, our boats and everything. We have lost everything for this man, Jesus. Now he says he's going to leave us. And the disciples could not digest that. And Jesus felt their anguish and their stress. And he says, "I will not leave you orphan." You know the word orphan in Tamil, in my language, meaning one who has lost direction. There is no direction, not knowing what to do, how to go about doing. Jesus says, "I will not leave you orphaned. I will not abandon you. I'm going, yes, but there will be somebody who will direct you, who will lead you to the truth, will show you the way, and that is the Holy Spirit, which we'll be celebrating week after, is the Pentecost. Orphan is one who has lost direction. You know, I don't think there is any orphanage here. There are a number of orphanages in India. We have for orphans, semi-orphans, broken families, alcoholic, abusive parents. These children come, if they have no other way, they come to this orphanage. When I was doing my philosophy in 92, I went to this orphanage for 2 years on weekend ministry. We were looking forward, we were three of us brothers going to this orphanage. We were looking forward to go to be with the children there. And the children were waiting and waiting for the day to come. Saturday, 4 o'clock, brothers would come. As soon as we reach, they all come, hug, and they're just around you all the time. They feel that love. They feel that they have been accepted. There is somebody coming for us. There is somebody. The orphans very often feel that the world of theirs is with nobody. They are by themselves. It is nobody to whom they can cling on to. They can confide with. There is nobody in the world. Is that feeling? That would be the worst feeling that anybody on earth can have. That I have nobody on earth. And that was the sense that the apostles felt. And Jesus says, I am not going to abandon you. Very many times we live in a world where, in today's world, we all live together, but still there will be some people feeling, having this sense of abandonment, loneliness, being castrated from the family, not connected, isolated, an hostile relationship. And they say the number of suicide rate is increasing among the young people. Why? They have everything. They have all gadgets, all social communication, but still they are lost. They have got everything in the world, but they have not received this love, unconditional love, acceptance, or the direction the parents have to give. The people at home have to give. Very many times they miss that, or they fail to see the direction that parents are showing. And today we are called to enhance our relationship, to grow in this relationship that Jesus asserts and confirms to his disciples. I will be with you till the end of the ages. And I will send you the Spirit who will lead you to the truth. And today we are called to be disciples to our children, to our family members, to our future generation, as the Spirit that leads to the truth. And that through the commandment of love, acceptance, to recognize their struggles and challenges. And Jesus did that. And we know what happened on the day of Pentecost. The disciples who felt that they have nobody on earth, locked themselves, scared of going out, come out with grace and blessing, with so much of fearlessness and confidence, because of the Spirit that led them to the truth. Very many times the truth is painful. Disciplining is painful. To take a principled way of life is hard. But Jesus wants us to follow him. The first reading, the gospel message is taken to the Samaritans. Samaritans felt that they were outcast, discriminated, kept away from the society, castrated from the society. And the gospel message reaches to them through the apostles. How? They have learned from their own master, Jesus Christ. Gospel of John, chapter 4, where Jesus has a dialogue with the Samaritan woman. And she says, how can you have? We are castrated. We are out of the society. And Jesus brings them to the mainstream that God loves everyone. Be it of different culture, race and color, whatever be it, God welcomes everyone. And that is what we are called. And Peter reminds us in the second reading, evil, get away with it. For God is the one who is the light. He will take us to the light. And that is Jesus Christ. And the gospel tells us that Jesus is our master. And it is to him that we need to abide, to follow, and to accept the commandments and to follow him. Very many times in our lives we think that I can program my life and I can order things in life. But often things don't turn out the way that I want. Things go out of our control. Things go out of our way. But the trust is that if we abide in His love, if we only depend, believe in Jesus, and then He is there to show us and lead us to the truth, and He is the truth, the way, and the life. And let us once again surrender ourselves, for He is our hope, He is our trust, and in Him we will find meaning and joy. And let us continue to grow in His love and be encircled by His love and in His grace, and live the commandments that He has given to us. Amen.